are there to give you the understanding that you have freedom of choice.
Okay. two kinds of sufferers in this world. Those who suffer from a lack of life, and those who suffer from an overabundance of life. I've always found myself in the second category. When you come to think of it, almost all human behavior and activity is not essentially any different from animal behavior. The most advanced technologies and craftsmanship bring us, at best, up to the super chimpanzee level. Actually, the gap between, say, Plato or Nietzsche and the average human is greater than the gap between that chimpanzee and the average human. The realm of the real spirit, the true artist, the saint, the philosopher, is rarely achieved. Why so few? Why is world history and evolution not stories of progress, rather this endless and futile addition of zeros? No greater values have developed. Hell, the Greeks, 3,000 years ago, were just as advanced as we are. But what are these barriers that keep people from reaching anywhere near their real potential? The answer to that can be found in another question, and that's this. Which is the most universal human characteristic? Fear or laziness?
Let's go! escaping light.
This can't be forever. This journey alone has made me tired, and I want to go home, but the child inside survive. The same darkness as I do, and that's what's making this difficult, because I can't bear thinking that my reasons to live are as broken as I am. Tortured, restless, feel like they don't mean anything. So I have to learn to let go of what is holding me back, and like the mountains, rivers, and the trees, embrace the winter that is killing me, or fail my purpose.
This is not a goodbye.